So let us study about the economic importance of this fungi in detail. So in my last class, we were studying the role of these particular fungi as decomposers, how actually they help in the process of the decomposition of the cellulose, where we studied the different organisms which are involved in the decomposition of the cellulose, the mechanism of decomposition, the enzymes which are involved in the process of the decomposition of the cellulose into the simpler form, which is one of an important component, polysaccharide in the cell wall of the plants. And also we studied the role of an enzyme pectinase in the decomposition of the pectin, which is also an important cell wall component of the plants. And also we studied the different organisms which are involved in the process of the decomposition of the pectin. So, and also we studied the role of these pectinase in different industries. And also we studied the role of lignin. Lignin is, as I had mentioned, this is one of an important polysaccharide which has been majorly used in the production of, in the process of the industries, especially in the process of the fuel, biofuel production. This particular lignin plays a major role. However, we know this particular lignin is an important cell wall component, and compared to all other polysaccharide, the composition of lignin is very high in plants. And the decomposition, if we talk about the decomposition of this particular lignin, most of the organisms, starting from bacteria, actinomycetes, or fungi, most of them may not have the ability of producing the enzyme and decompose this particular lignin. But we know that there are certain basidiomycetes fungi and few ascomycetes fungi. Basidiomycetes fungi, especially the Ephelophorales and Agaricales, all these mushrooms, they have an ability of producing an enzyme lactase. These enzyme lactase plays a major role of breaking down this complex lignin into the simpler form. Later, the simpler form of this particular lignin is being further decomposed by various other enzymes, say for example, hemicellulase, cellulase, xylase, etc. They play a major role, which has been produced by some of the bacteria as well as some of the molds they produce. So, and also this particular lactase enzyme has been extensively used in various industries. And also we studied about there are certain fungi which plays a major role in deterioration of this particular wood. And this particular biodeterioration, there are certain fungi, as I had mentioned in my previous class, they have an ability of producing various pigment onto this particular decaying wood. This particular ability of producing this particular pigment has been variously exploited by us in making various wooden wares, as well as, see, for example, jewelry box, where they give a particular kind of ornamentation or a particular kind of the prettiness of this particular wood become a major role. And also it has been extensively used in market and has got a high economic value. And also we studied one more aspect of this particular fungi infecting a particular kind of wood, for example, a plant called as Aquilaria, where this Aquilaria agalocha has been infected by few of this particular fungi, especially the Epicocum granulatum, which has been extensively studied. This particular fungi gives a particular odor or a smell to this particular wood, where that particular wood has been marketed as agar wood and it has got a high economic value. And also I have listed out the various wood decaying fungi, where dominantly it is the basidiomycetes fungi which plays a major role in decomposing the wood, and few of the ascomycetes fungi, few of the molds also plays an important role in decomposition of the wood. As well as also we studied the particular fungi also plays a major role in the spoilage of paper, especially the molds, anamorphic fungi belonging to the subdivision Deuteromycotina plays a major role in spoilage of paper that we would have come across. And also we studied about the deterioration of the textiles. And one important interesting fact is the marine fungus, that is Zalerion species, which is one of a marine fungus, aquatic fungus, which has an ability of damaging the twines and ropes, which has been extensively used in building up of this boat, ships and all. This, if this particular twine and ropes has been extensively damaged by this particular fungi, it is very much a loss, economical loss. Also, we studied the deterioration of the leather, which would have come across in our day-to-day life. And also, we studied the bio-deterioration of optical equipment, especially our microscope students. You would have observed the microscope. Many a times, we feel that, see, our oil immersion is not working. Our objective is not working. Why? Because if we have used the oil, cedarwood oil, and if we would have focused, if we would have not cleaned that particular objective, so what happened? The fungus. Fungus, this group of fungi, especially this Aspergillus, Penicillium, these particular organism infects this particular optical equipment, and that makes our lens also blur. Likewise, we have rubber products, which has been extensively damaged or deteriorated by Aspergillus species and all. Paints, this would have come across in our house also. Sometimes due to the wettening of the wall and all, the paints also get deteriorated. We would have come across this Aspergillus black patches here and there on the walls. Penicillium, Cladosporium species, they have an ability of deteriorating this paints also. Likewise, we have electrical equipments, wires and all, which gets sometimes even inside the fridge and all, sometimes the fungus grows, that we would have come across. Likewise, the fuel, especially the kerosene fuel, also get deteriorated. Please make a note, it is Amorphotheca resini. This is very much important. This is one of a fungus, anamorphic fungi, which has an ability of deteriorating kerosene. Likewise, we also study fungi play a major role in spoilage of food, where we have would have seen all this in our day-to-day life. The bread, which would have got infected by the rhizopus, aspergillus, anthracnose. This is also the, especially the fruits, vegetables, where you can find the water-soaked lesions. These are the water-soaked lesions which have been formed during the process of post-harvest storage, or if the storage is not properly maintained, such kind of anthracnose can be observed, especially due to the contamination or the infection with Colitotrichum species. And also we have studied the rottening of the citrus fruit, that also would have seen, especially due to the Penicillium species. And also many of the vegetables which are rich in starch, especially they get rot due to the contamination or the infection. If the storage is not proper, gets infected with rhizopus species. So likewise, we have some of the food products, especially this also would have seen in our house. If the storage is not proper, the spoilage of the pickles, jams, jellies, meat and all can happen due to the contamination with many of the yeast-like organism like Rhodotorula, Candida species, Pichia species, Aspergillus species, Penicillium, Rhizopus and all. See, these kind of contamination happen if the storage is being not properly done. If the storage is also been properly done, sometimes canning, if it is not proper, there are certain organisms, especially there are certain organisms, say for example, Telaromyces species, Bisoclamis species, where these fungi are even resistant to pasteurization, would have pasteurized something and would have canned that. The pasteurization, these usually at that particular point of the boiling of any of the food or water or whatever it is, if the pasteurization has been done, most of the organism get destroyed, especially bacillus may not, but frequent pasteurization, if it has been done, even the bacillus has an ability, because this bacillus produces certain endospores, we know that. So however, many of the fungi and many vegetative bacteria get destroyed at that particular point of the boiling, at that particular holding temperature. So there are certain fungi where they can withstand even that particular pasteurization, like our bacillus species. And also we use certain preservatives we use for the preparation of jam, jellies and all. There are certain fungi which has an ability of even resistant to those preservatives, and they start growing, so contaminating our canned food. Likewise, apart from causing those harmful effect. They also cause mycotoxin. If by chance, if such kind of contaminated food is being used by animals or human, we may get infected and many diseases can happen. These are the list of fungi and these are the list of mycotoxin. Please make a note. And also this, I have taken it from Aneja and Mehrotra. You can just go in through that. Mycotoxin, the questions can be asked. Well, for example, aflatoxin, which is an organism, has an ability of producing aflatoxin. It is Aspergillus flavus, Aspergillus parasiticus. What diseases it causes? Aflatoxinosis. So such kind of citrinine. So likewise, you have to remember this group of fungi, which has an ability of producing such kind of mycotoxin and what disease they cause, that I have listed out here. So you can refer Aneja. Of course, I will share you this PPT also. And apart from those mycotoxins, there are certain, all those, whatever I have listed out here, they're all molds, you know, the fungi can be classified based on their morphology, yeast, molds, and mushrooms. What are yeast? Single-celled organisms are called as yeast. The molds, filamentous forms, are called as molds. All your Aspergillus, Penicillium, all these are molds. And if they are forming some macroscopic structures, basidiocarps or ascocarp, they are called as mushrooms. So there are mushrooms, as I had mentioned in my previous class also, there are certain poisonous, highly toxic mushroom. One of the highly toxic mushroom, which is poisonous than that of a venom of the snake, is the toxin which has been produced by Amanita muscaria, where it produces a toxin called as phyllotoxin, amatoxins. These toxins, muscisol, this is also, and also it is hallucinogenic. They produce certain compounds which are hallucinogenic. You know what is hallucinogenic? They go for, if a person consumes such thing, they go for hallucination, some kind of imagination. They will go into their own world. That's called as hallucinogenic. So, and also one more interesting is, as I had mentioned, psilocybe. Psilocybe is also one of a mushroom where the spore, yesterday Harshini was also talking about the spore color. Based upon the spore color, yesterday she was talking how actually the spore print of the mushroom has been taken. She was mentioning that there are some spores, basidiospores, which are white in color, green in color, pink in color, black in color, brown in color, and also she was mentioning how to take the spore print. See, for example, if this is a mushroom, you know, this is phyllus. This is a stipe and this is a phyllus. Umbrella like structure is a phyllus. You just cut open this phyllus and take out this stipe, take out this phyllus, that cup like structure, and place one paper and in inverted like a cup, how you will place it in inverted position, in the same way you place it on that particular white paper or any colored paper. Better to go for white paper. After some time, you leave it for some time. What happened? Whatever the spores, you know, basidiospores are produced in this gill region, they just go and land on the surface of this particular white paper. So what happened? That particular print, whatever has been obtained, is called as spore print. The spore print plays a major role in taxonomy of the fungi, taxonomy of this particular mushrooms. There are certain mushrooms which are white colored mushroom. They have been placed in separate order. There are a separate family. There are certain brown colored spores. Say, for example, the psilocybe, this is one of the mushroom which belongs to the class Coprinaceae. So where they produce a certain brown colored spores, there are certain coprinous species, you know, they produce black colored spores. So here I wanted to just tell you that spores, basidiospores, the color of the basidiospores plays a major role in taxonomy of the fungi. So likewise, there is a particular fungi called as psilocybin. It's called as magic fungi because this is one of the fungi. It is cultivated. No particular government license has been given for the cultivation of this, but for some medicinal properties, medicinal use, this particular magic mushroom psilocybe has been cultivated, and the psilocybin has been extracted and used for the medicinal purpose. So likewise, I have listed out few toxic mushroom also, and also I discussed that fungi also plays a major role in causing various diseases, where I have listed out wilt disease in case of tomatoes, brinjal, elm, especially elm wilt. which has been caused by Aphistostoma species. Please make a note of all this pathogen and the disease they cause. Very important for the point of your competitive examination. And especially, as I was always mentioning, the blight disease of potatoes, late blight of potato, and early blight of potato, especially this is being given for matching. So early blight caused by Alternaria solani, late blight called by Phytophthora infesta, and likewise you have damping of disease, anthracnose, many other diseases. We also discussed about powdery mildew disease, rust disease, downy mildew disease, smut disease, etc., where various pathogen infects the plant and cause various diseases. And also, apart from this plant disease, there are also various diseases which is being caused by fungi even onto the human. Especially, they cause the disease in case of human. In my seminar, we were also discussing about fungi as a parasites. So she was talking about the parasitic fungi which causes disease in human. She had also classified this particular disease as superficial, cutaneous, subcutaneous, systemic, and opportunistic. So superficial, what is the superficial? Superficial, the infection which happen superficially, especially on the hair or a dead layer of this dead layer, dead cells will be there. On that particular superficial infection which happened, that is called as superficial fungal infection. Cutaneous, where the infection happened onto the epidermis, which happens onto the nails, which happen to the hairs, that's called as cutaneous infection. Likewise, you have subcutaneous infection. Just beneath the epidermis, the infection happened. Dermis, subcutis, the infection happen onto the skin. That is called as, say, for example, this is superficial, only on the surface you could see the infection. Where you can find just onto the skin, epidermis, the infection has happened. This is subcutaneous, just below the epidermis, dermis, subcutis region, the infection has happened. That's called as subcutaneous infection. You have systemic infection, where the infection happen into the internal organs of the human. That is called as systemic infection. Likewise, you have certain opportunistic infection which happen into the internal organs. If, for example, we know the infection which happen onto the especially onto the lungs, especially our aspergillosis, pneumocystis, which causes pneumonia-like infection, candidiasis, and cryptococcus infection. These are some of the opportunistic infection which has been caused by various causative agent. The major group of fungi which causes this infection are, remember, trichosporon species, trichophyton species, mycosporum species, epidermophyton species, candida species, histoplasma species, and aspergillus candida. These are some of the major group of fungi which causes various disease even in human. That we have studied. So we studied the role of this fungi in causing diseases in plants and also the diseases in human. And apart from this, they are also found to be entomophilic. What is the meaning of entomophilic? Entomophilic, or can anybody tell what is entomophilic? Even you could see all these images and you can let me know what are entomophilic. Yes,
insects.
They infect the insect.
Yeah, insects. Are there any economic role of exploiting this particular fungi?
Insecticide.
Yes.
Insecticide.
Yes,
insecticide.
They have been used as a insecticide, biopesticide, in order to control this particular insect pest. So students, kindly remember, even there are many pests which causes infection, Lepidopteran larvae or any of the grasshopper or any of this kind of bugs which causes infection. There are many research has happened and it has been found that many of the anamorphic fungi, the fungi which belongs to the Deuteromycotina, they play a major role in controlling. Still lots of investigation can happen. So why not mosquitoes? Mosquitoes, still, so I have read some papers. Even there are certain fungi which has an ability to get parasitized on this particular mosquitoes. Why can't we do some more research on controlling this particular mosquitoes using such kind of entomophilic fungi? So however, I have listed out some of the fungi which are found to be entomophilic and which causes infection in many arthropods. And apart from all this harmful effect, we can also expect some useful aspects of this particular fungi in various industries. There are n number of industrial applications of this particular fungi, especially the Saccharomyces species has been extensively used in the production of beverage alcohol, industrial alcohol, especially in fuel industries. Especially this Saccharomyces species can be highly exploited for the production of various ethanols. It can be a beverage ethanol or an industrial ethanol. And also we know various organic acids, the fungi has an ability of producing various organic acids, especially the citric acid, itaconic acid, fumaric acid, malic acid, benzoic acid, which has been, so students kindly note these, whatever the examples I have given over here, please make a note, very much important for your competitive examination students. Kindly make a note, citric acid, matching they can ask, citric acid, aspergillus, niger. Say for, likewise, you have benzoic acid, which has been extensively used in pharmaceutical industries. You would have seen some of the ointments where they have used this benzoic acid, which has been extensively used, where aspergillus flavus, aspergillus oryzae has an ability of producing this benzoic acid, which is being extensively used in pharmacy. And also we know this particular fungi are being extensively used in the production of various antibiotics, say for example, penicillin, cephalosporin, griselflavin, only few I have elaborated over here. So which the majority of this fungi has an ability, still lots of research is been happening and many others are there, few we have listed out and in textbooks we can get this, but there is lots of research has happened. Still we can go for further research in extracting this particular antibiotics, especially the endophytes. There are many medicinal plants which is been not yet reported, where there are many medicinal plants where in Ayurveda, Siddhi and all, they extensively use these plants in healing various diseases. But we know that this particular plants, whichever the medicinal plants or whatever it is, they have endophytic fungi in them. Why can't we use those endophytic fungi? Why can't we take out this secondary metabolites from them and use them? You know, the medicinal plants, they are seasonal, and also only fruit, for example, fruits can produce certain particular secondary metabolite or the root. So instead of exploiting them from the plants which are seasonal and it requires large number of space and all, agricultural land and all, we have to take out and grow this medicinal plant. Why not if the fungi themselves has an ability of producing them, which are endophytes, where we can grow this particular fungi in vitro condition and the mass production can be done and the yield can also be better, we don't know. So such kind of research can happen. So likewise, we have vitamins, especially vitamin B12, beta carotenoid, which has been produced by some of the rhizopus species also. Ashby gossypii is there, black scilla trispora is there. And likewise, we have various other industrial applications, many statins, especially the lowest statin is being produced by one of a fungi called as Monoascus rubrum, where it has been statins. What is the statins? Especially mevastatin is there, lovastatin is there, where these statins has an ability of controlling this particular cholesterol, especially, you know, the BP tablets, whatever our elders, they are using. Why they are using? In order to control or the cholesterol, isn't it? So there are certain statin where they have an ability of controlling this particular, lowering the cholesterol level. So some of the research which has happened with respect to the molds, especially monoascus is giving a very good results. Penicillium is also giving a very good results. In our laboratory, in our Ramayya college, myself as a principal investigator, we had extracted this lower statin from mushroom, where it was our team which was reported that for the first time, and that even there are certain mushrooms, especially it was, I mean, I think you would have seen those posters also in our laboratory. So we have a schizophyllum species, schizophyllum. This is one of a mushroom which gives a production of this lower statin. When compared to monoascus rubrum, it is giving a better results. So students, the why I'm telling this, such kind of research should more happen. So we, which are the genes involved in the production of that particular lower statin? Why can't we screen that particular gene? Why can't we do the recombinant DNA technology? Why can't we prepare some other like recombinant for E. coli? We can add that particular gene, and the production can become easier. Such kind of research, students, you people have to take up. So likewise, we have erotin, which has been extensively produced by ergotin, erotin produced by Claviceps species, which has been extensively used. Even though this ergotin, which has been produced by, we have studied the Claviceps species, which has been extensively used. It is a mycotoxin also. Even though this erotin, which has been produced by Claviceps, has got a major role in, especially during the childbirth. They give that as an injection so that the contraction of the uterus happen, so that the labor, the delivery of that particular baby become easier. So it has been used, extensively used in medicine. Likewise, you have trichothecin. This is one of a antifungal substance which has been produced by Trichoderma roseum. So this particular antifungals, we have very less amount of research with respect to antifungal. Nystatin is one of a fungi, is antifungal drug, especially they have been used. Still, lots of research should happen in this particular field, antifungal drug production. So, and also apart from the use of this particular fungi in the production of various organic acid, in the production of alcohol, in the production of vitamins, in the production of antibiotics, in the production of various statins, the enzymes which they produce, starting from amylase, cellulase, protease, lipase, all these enzymes has been extensively used in various industries, starting from food industries, fermentation industries, or meat processing industries, leather industries, they have been extensively used. And one more thing, you have mucor, mealy. This is one of a fungi which has been extensively exploited for the production of rennet. Rennet is one of a enzyme which has been especially produced in the elementary canal of the rodents. Especially in goat, sheep, and all. So here, this particular fungi has an ability of producing this rennet. This rennet has been extensively used in cheese production. Likewise, you have pectinase, invertase. You know what is invertase? This is an enzyme which has been produced by yeast, especially the Saccharomyces species, which has been extensively used in confectionaries. Likewise, you have xylase enzyme produced by Trichoderma species, where they have an ability of decomposing lignin. As I was mentioning, lignin is a polysaccharide which can be decomposed by the enzyme called as lacase. The especially the basidiomycetes fungi, white rot fungi, has an ability of producing this lignin. Once the lignin is broken down, the next enzyme which has been involved in the breaking down of the lignin is xylanase. So this particular xylanase has been produced by various molds. One of an organism called as Trichoderma ricci has a production of, the production is better when compared to that of other fungi. So likewise, we have the role of this particular fungi as food also. So, dear students, I have only 5 minutes time. If you have any doubts,